Start with Rahul Gandhi stating categorically that he would not continue as Congress president. One uncertainty that had gripped the party has ended. But this culmination does not end the disorder and chaos in the party, which is in a state of paralysis since its rout in the parliamentary election. Mr. Gandhi's letter of resignation is part self-reflection about the Congress in general and his own personal role in it, and part a critique of the state of affairs of Indian politics. Mr. Gandhi felt the need for introspection and accountability and restated his long-held position that he was in politics not for power but social change. By sticking to his decision to quit as party chief, he has thrown a challenge at his colleagues to find a life outside the shelter of the Nehru Gandhi family. The coterie that flourished around his mother and predecessor Sonia Gandhi had reduced politics to manipulation and turned the party into an instrument of vested interests. A small club of self-seekers who reinforce one another and don't face the electorate had taken over the Congress years before Mr. Gandhi came on the scene. His letter is an indictment of these leaders whose personal fortunes never waned, even as the parties plummeted. Mr. Gandhi's limitation is not in his understanding of the challenges before the party or the country, or in his vision for both. His inexact articulation is not reflective of any insurmountable weaknesses. His real failure has been his inability to free the party from the clutches of what his father Rajiv Gandhi had famously called power brokers. In calling for accountability, he is effectively asking a group to self-destruct for the larger cause of the party, which in turn must fight for the larger cause of the country. By refusing to be the facade for their parasitical existence, Mr. Gandhi might have forged a productive churn at all levels. Any moral appeal could only have had a limited impact on the seasoned veterans, but the example Mr. Gandhi set by accepting reasonability for the defeat while reiterating his commitment to the larger cause might help inspire a resuscitation of the party. But questions abound. Mr. Gandhi himself will remain active in politics as he has made clear, but how much authority he would want to exercise remains an open question. His insistence on stepping aside also comes from a realization that the dynasty tag is more a drag than a booster for his politics and the party in the current environment. The process of reducing the Congress to a family enterprise had started with Mr. Gandhi's forebearers and their supporters as much as their opponents. Only a family member could have sought to challenge the notion that the Congress cannot survive without the dynasty if the absence of a Nehru Gandhi at the helm was a precondition for the reconfiguration of the Congress and the formation of a viable, alternative to Hindutva, Mr. Gandhi has created that situation. Congress MP Rahul Gandhi is to appear in a local court in Bihar on July 6 in connection with a defamation case filed against him by senior state BJP leader and Deputy Chief Minister Sushil Kumar Modi over the Modi surname Zaib made during the Lok Sabha election campaign. State Congress President Madan Mohan Jha confirmed Mr. Gandhi's visit, but details of his tour program in the state have not been confirmed yet, he said. Mr. Gandhi, while addressing an election rally at Kolar in Karnataka on April 13, allegedly said, be it Nirav Modi, Lalit Modi or Narendra Modi, all has a common surname. Why? All thieves have a common surname. Mr. Sushil Kumar Modi found Mr. Gandhi's statement offensive and derogatory and had filed a defamation case under Section 500 of the Indian Penal Code against him in a local court in Patna on April 18. He had also sought an apology from Mr. Gandhi. Meanwhile, some state Congress leaders on Thursday sought the resignation of RJD leader Tejaswi Yadav from the post of the leader of opposition in the assembly for the election debacle. Following the example of our party president Rahul Gandhi, Tejaswi Yadav, who was the face of the opposition and led its campaign during the last Lok Sabha poll in Bihar, too, should step down from the post of opposition leader in the assembly, state Congress leader Rajesh Kumar said. Rejecting the demand, RJD leader and party spokesperson Bhai Birendra said, Tejaswi is not a leader who will leave the responsibility of leading the opposition midway. After a prolonged absence, Mr. Yadav attended the assembly on Thursday but did not speak to the media. Earlier, he had tweeted to say that he was absent for long as he was undergoing treatment for a ligament and ACL injury. However, the ruling NDA leaders have been taking pot shots over his prolonged absence. Full stop. Over.